Now we'll look at three examples of using a tape diagram or bar diagram to help solve percent problems. In part A, if $300 is increased by 25%, what is the new amount? So we'll use this bar to determine 25% of 300, and then we'll add that amount to 300 to determine the new value. We'll label the dollar values along the bottom and the percents along the top. So we'll label the far left of the bar $0 and the far right $300. And because 100% divided by 25% is equal to 4, we'll divide the bar into 4 equally sized parts or pieces. Labeling the percents along the top, we would start at 0% on the left and go up to 100% on the far right, counting by 25%. So we have 25%, 50%, 75%, and 100%. And now we'll divide 300 by 4 to determine what to count by along the bottom. So $300 divided by 4 is equal to $75. So we'll count by $75 along the bottom. So we'd have $75, $150, $225, and $300. Now using the bar, we can see that 25% of 300 is $75. And therefore, if $300 is increased by 25%, it's increased by $75. Because 300 plus 75 is equal to 375, the new amount is $375. Now for part B, we're asked, what is 19% of 120? It's difficult to determine 19% of 120 using the bar. So what we'll do is find 20% of 120 using the bar and then subtract 100% of 20 from that amount. Along the bottom of the bar, we'll label 0 on the left, 120 on the right. Because we're going to use the bar to find 20% of 120, and 100% divided by 20% is equal to 5, we divide the bar into 5 equally sized parts or pieces. Labeling the percents along the top, we'll have 0% on the left, 100% on the right. So 0% on the left, 100% on the right, and that will count by 20%. So 20%, 40%, 60%, 80%, and 100%. And now to determine how to count along the bottom, we'll divide 120 by 5. 120 divided by 5 is equal to 24, so we'll count by 24s along the bottom. So we have 0, 24, 48, 72, 96, and 120. So now using the bar, we can see that 20% of 120 is 24. But we want 19%, so if we can find 1% of 120, we would subtract this amount from 24. Well, 1% of 120 is 120 divided by 100, which is equal to 1.2. So 19% of 120 is 24 minus 1.2, which equals 22.8. So 22.8 is 19% of 120. Let's look at one more example. Joe went to an athletic store to purchase new running shoes. To his surprise, the store was having a 20% off athletic shoes sale. He purchased a new pair of shoes that were regularly priced $60. How much did Joe pay for his shoes? So to answer this question, we'll use the bar to determine 20% of 60, and then we'll subtract that amount from $60 to determine how much he paid for the shoes. Because we'll use the bar to show percents of $60, we'll label $0 on the far left and $60 on the far right. And because 100% divided by 20% is equal to 5, we divide the bar into 5 equally sized parts or pieces. Labeling the percents along the top, we have 0% on the left, 100% on the right, and we count by 20%. So 20%, 40%, 60%, 80%, and 100%. And now to determine how to count along the bottom, we divide $60 by 5, $60 divided by 5 is equal to $12. So we have $0, $12, $24, $36, $48, and $60. So using the bar, we can see that 20% of $60 is $12, and therefore Joe saved $12 from the sale. Joe paid $60 minus 20%, which is minus $12, which is equal to $48. So Joe paid $48 for his shoes. I hope you found this helpful.